How to use the new Composition 8 multi-component search function. The new Composition 8 search allows to quickly identify unknown pure substances and mixtures. It will generate a multitude of possible results in one single run and automatically select the most suitable one. In this tutorial, we will demonstrate the function by analyzing a three-component solvent mixture containing acetone, ethanol and isopropanol. The Composition 8 search can be called from touch via multiple locations. First, it can be called from the identification workflow, where it replaces the old mixture analysis function. Second, it can be added to the toolbar of the analysis workflow and the spectra view. Finally, there's a dedicated Composition 8 workflow that allows direct identification of unknown mixtures and pure components. This tutorial will use the dedicated 8 workflow for demonstration, but the handling from the other locations is exactly the same. Besides selecting the appropriate libraries, no other user inputs are required prior to the analysis. Start the workflow via the Composition 8 icon on the home screen. The first step is to measure a background by pressing Measure Background. The next step is the sample measurement. Type in the sample information and position your sample. Then press Start Sample Measurement. When the measurement is done, the analysis starts automatically. Please note that the library extraction step will be performed only once in a session. Finally, we see the result of the search. The algorithm will place a trophy icon on the recommended and most plausible result. On the panel on the left side, you can deactivate or activate the composite spectrum, which is a synthetic spectrum calculated from the individual component spectra. Also, you can activate the different spectrum, which is calculated by subtracting the composite spectrum from the measured spectrum. The straighter the curve is, the better. You can browse through the results by selecting the entries from the list. Use the slider to change the number of components. You can mark your favorite results by clicking on the star icon to the right of the entry. Use the filter icon on top to only show your favorite results. The trophy icon will always show the result recommended by the algorithm. As you can see, our mixture was correctly identified, since ethyl alcohol is a synonym for ethanol and 2-propanol is a synonym for isopropanol. The colored bar under the individual results shows you how much of the spectrum is explained by the individual components. The white part at the end of the bar shows the unexplained part. Directly to the right side of the bar you can see the hit quality that ranges from 0 to 1000, with 1000 being a perfect match. To further investigate results, you can click on the Fit Check button in the upper right corner. On top, you can see the spectra window, which can also be enlarged. At the bottom right is the component table for the currently displayed hit. On the left side, you can see a grid that shows you all the results in a coordinate system with the number of components on the x-axis and the hit quality on the y-axis. You can change the metric of the y-axis via the drop-down list. We recommend to use hit value. Click on any of the points to show the result. Navigation is also possible by using the arrow buttons. You can also zoom in, double-click or tap in order to zoom out. Again, you can use the star icon to mark your favorites. Use the filter icon to show only the favorite results. In the table on the right, you can see the individual components of the selected result together with the percentage value. This value shows how much the component contributes to the calculated composite spectrum and should not be taken as a full quantitative result. Selected component spectrum is marked with a blue frame and will be shown in the spectra view on top. You can also display multiple spectra at once by clicking on the pin icon to the right of the entry. Remove the selected spectra individually or all at once. Click on the crosshair icon on the left of a component to only show results that contain that very component. This is especially useful when you are sure that the component is indeed part of the mixture. This can be done with multiple components and is directly reflected in the grid view of the results. You can deactivate the selected components individually or all at once by using the icon on the right. Finally, you can click on Print Report in order to generate a report, or on Next Sample in order to measure the next sample. You now know how to use Composition ID.